tall poppy syndrome. So much has been said. You'd think that we would have kicked it to the curb by now. You've put me off by saying that. I can't even read this. The new research on our young people has concluded that not only is it still around, it's more prevalent than ever.
Well, a media student in Auckland has also been on the receiving end, but instead of withering, she rose up and made a doco about it. Here's Carolyn Robinson.
Ayeesha Taylor has found a life with her lens. Her travels inspired a photography business, and her pictures speak a thousand uplifting words. But fulfilling her passion has brought something else sharply into focus.
I've definitely been called like a try-hard or, yeah, too confident. Confident is always, almost always mistaken as cockiness in New Zealand. I literally had a friend ask me the other day, she was like, do you even make money from your prints? And that really surprised me because she knows that I do, but it's almost like a little kick in the back.
She put the rucksack down to come home and study documentary making, turning her lens on tall poppy syndrome.
I started to do some research, Googling 10 influential and successful young Kiwis. 8 of them referred to the syndrome and the impact it had on them.
She reached out on social media to see if everyday Kiwis felt the same and was overwhelmed with the response.
I was blown away realising how many people it was actually affecting.
Some of our tallest poppies were keen to share their experiences.
I was a teenage girl and I was on the telly and I would, you know, kind of go out and people would pour drinks on me or be rude and mean to me. And people warn you, they go, oh, well, once your episode's here, get ready.
So I think maybe people just think, oh, she woke up one day and then she was a Olympian.
With that success comes this kind of obligation to not be proud of that.
I remember in school, like, you literally had to call yourself ugly, say that you were fat for people to be like, oh, she's not cocky. Like, you literally had to drag yourself down. And I think that's a massive thing as well, is that we often cut ourselves down as well.
And it's something we're still handing down.
It's because I'm quite good at sports, so, but I think a lot of people don't really like that, like me for that reason. A lot of people don't like me that.
There was, or still is, question and answer anonymous websites where you can send people hateful messages.
But I honestly think it's like a two-sided coin because there are so many positive things to social media. Like,
sure.
those tall poppies can go and find their community. If you do put yourself out there on social media, if you do stand out, it's so much easier to cut you down.
Right.
You know,
right.
And often tall poppy syndrome is so subtle. And that's why it's so hard to, like, almost diagnose, because it could be such a simple thing as, like, someone just not liking a post of you, I don't know, maybe graduating. Mm.
Everyone stop being dicks is the moral of the story.
Ayeesha's got plenty of enthusiastic support for her project. She's entered it into a film festival, hoping her message will flourish.
And that's why I'm kind of speaking out, because it's literally getting passed down to future generations and it needs to come to a stop.
It's a bit of a Kiwi and Australian thing, isn't it, the old talk? Because we like modest people.
We don't
like anybody, you know, being proud of their achievements, and yet good on them.
Yes, but I think it's less and less tall poppy syndrome in New Zealand. I think America, certainly a lot less over there. People celebrate success. But we are very humble people, New Zealanders.
Yeah, we are. But let's celebrate that success, eh?